welcome to a new video in Windows 10 series. In my last video, I have explained you about Unicode text format and how a Windows PC is representing the Unicode text in olden days. Basically, it is with code pages and all. So if you didn't watch my first video, please go and watch first, then you will get more idea and base to watch this video. So guys, please watch the first video first. So in this video, I am going to explain you more about Unicode text format. So basically, my plan is to cover these things in this video. At first, I will give you a detailed introduction of Unicode text format, explaining how this data is represented in these different Unicode text format. And I will also give some demos like in user point of view, like in a Windows 10 PC, how you can type a Unicode text. And I will also give some demo like how you can represent these different Unicode text format in Windows Notepad application. And I will also discuss about some advanced topics like how a text editor application can understand a Unicode text by just manipulating these bytes. And I will also give more insight into some other advanced topics. So guys, keep watching. This video will give complete guide to a Unicode text format. Hi guys, I will give you a detailed introduction to Windows 10 Unicode text format. So Unicode itself is a standard, and this standard is used to unify all the characters across the world. So for each character, there should be some number assigned to it. So if I want to explain it correctly, I need to explain you some terminologies used in Unicode standard. So this is the Unicode website, and you can see there are many Unicode characters are represented in this website they were showing to us. And if you notice here, there is some numbers like this one, U+0D26. Similarly, there are many numbers here. What is this number? So I will explain you this, like 4 point, like. So basically, this number is in Unicode, it is explained as a code point. Code point is just a number that is assigned to every character. So if you say character A, there should be some code point assigned to it. Similarly, for all characters in the world, there should be a specific number assigned to it. And in our Unicode world, we will talk you this as a code point. So what is a Unicode format means? A Unicode format can support all the code points that represent the characters in the world. So I will show you some format like 0041. This represent character A. This means here you can see U means it itself means it's Unicode. 0041 is the specific code point assigned to character A. Similarly, for character B, it should be like 0042 and character B. And here one more thing is that this code point is in hexadecimal, and the first 200 means represent the first byte, and 41 represent the second byte. 41's corresponding decimal value is 65, and if you check the ASCII value for A, it should be 41, like 41 means character A. So that's all about a small introduction to Unicode character, how it is represented, how a code point is assigned to a Unicode character. We more look into Unicode text format and what are the characters are supported in Unicode text format. Majorly, there are around many code points are there, but still very commonly used code points in the first 64k code points. That means first 64,000 characters are the basic characters that are generally used in PCs. So it is denoted as a basic multilingual plane. The first 64k characters are basic multilingual plane, and so there should be many planes, like many planes are represented in a Unicode text format, and each plane represent 64k characters or 64k code points. So that is the basic idea how a Unicode standard is used to represent the characters. So Unicode itself, meaning that it denotes some characters or numbers is assigned to each character. That is the basic idea. But still, for encoding these characters, there are different ways in Unicode. So I can show you that here. Like, there are basically majorly three variant encoding forms, like UTF-8, UTF-16, and UTF-32. So what is UTF-8? UTF itself is a Unicode standard, and UTF-8 is the main commonly used in HTML and any HTTP protocol and in internet. It is very famous. So all are nowadays using UTF-8 format for their encoding format in Unicode world. So UTF-8 main peculiarity is that it supports ASCII character, mean that in older days we were using ASCII to represent characters, but still this ASCII is compatible with the UTF-8. How this compatibility work means, in ASCII each character is represented as one byte. So for character A is represented as one byte. Similarly in UTF-8, for ASCII character, UTF-8 is representing it by using one byte. So it is backward compatible with ASCII. So in that way, it is very convenient to use UTF-8 as an encoding form for Unicode format, because it is backward compatible with ASCII. UTF-16, it is a different encoding form used. Basically, it uses 2 bytes to represent a data, character data. So that is the basic difference between UTF-8 and UTF-16. And in UTF-32, it is just different. It uses 4 bytes to represent every character. So this is the main difference between these three, like how much byte it is used to represent the characters in Unicode. So this is the basic idea.
So let us take a look at how a Unicode text is processed by an application. So just imagine one situation that in a notepad or a text editor, you are typing some text, how it is rendered to the screen as a character. So in Unicode perspective, when you type some characters, like for example, when you type a character T, the corresponding Unicode code point is U+0054. So the application detect the key is pressed by, T, just by mapping the keys Unicode 0054. So from Unicode side, it is only the detection logic only. There is no rendering like how the character should be displayed. It is not specified in the Unicode standard. So it is all about, it is only talking about the standard, is just talking about encoding semantics only. Not how the character is typed, or how the character is rendered to the screen. It is all about the application and all about the font that specify how to render the particular character to the screen. So Unicode as a standard, it is not specifying nothing about how the shape of the character and how this character is rendered to the screen. Nothing is specified in the standard. Standard is just, it's in an abstract layer. It is only specifying just a conversion, like what character is typed. That's all. Font is specifying a visual representation of a character. So it is all about the font that define how to display the particular Unicode character. Okay, let's take a look at how a code, Unicode, assign a code point to a character. So if you take a look at here, you can see that how Unicode standard assign code point to a character. So for example, for each character you prefix it plus a u plus sign, and for example code point u plus 0041, that will represent decimal 65, which means it's character A. And also they will denote the same with a name also, like not only just a code, code, they will also give a particular name for that code point. So for character A, standard is defining Latin capital letter A. This is the corresponding unique name assigned for code point 0041. So that's how they define these character codes. So apart from this, there are many other, as a standard, there are many other rules and regulations that Unicode standard is considering when they are defining some new codes or something. So if you check the Unicode website, you can get more insight and more details on how they are dealing this as a standard, they are dealing how these characters are representing everything. So yeah, that's all about an introduction to Unicode. So now let us, okay guys, we already covered introduction to Unicode text format and different types of Unicode text format, all these steps. So now I am going to give you a demo in Windows 10 PC how you can type a Unicode text character. Like this is, I'm using a notepad, so let's start the demo. Like how I'm just opening a notepad, and if I want to type some Unicode character, Windows has a very useful tool like char map. So this tool will allow you to enter Unicode characters to any text editor. Like this is now unique, you can select any font here. I just selected any font, like any font. So I just selected Secure UI, and you can see many characters, like all characters are here. You can select any of those characters. For example, if I type A, you can see here that code point is U plus 0041 and the name is Latin capital letter A. And if you want to select that particular character, you can just select, copy, and here you can paste, control V. So that's it. Similarly, if you want to select any other character, for example, like some characters like this, if you want to select this character, you just need to select it, select, and then it is Arabic letter sheen. So I'm just going to copy it and I'm pasting it. So here you can see that character came like. So this is how you can use Windows PC. You can type any Unicode character in Windows PC. And one thing you noted, that all these characters, there should be some code point, but each character may be rendered or displayed to a screen differently. Like just when you change some font, like for example like this font, the same code, character code, is represented, displayed to the screen in a different way. That means the Unicode code is same, but only difference is in the font. So the each font represent the glyph, like